Here we go. Full schedule Saturday. Just booked my 12:30, which is going to be my lunch hour. And now what am I going to get something to eat? I'm going to try and squeeze in at 10. Oh, man, this is the life of a realtor right here. Good morning, Forest Ranch. First offer in, 42,000 over list. It's going to be a good day. Nice gentle Saturday. Plantation shutters all around. We got the fans in every bedroom. Love that. People just love this house. It's so tuned up. It's lightly used. How about these floors? There's not a scratch. Never had a dog. Never had a cat. Look brand new. Whole house feels new, which is rare in a family neighborhood after 10, 12 years. Regular family is going to put some wear and tear on it. We made this one look good. The COVID disclosure is part of the environment. Everyone has to sign one before showing. I'll come back to that as far as what I think about that. But when people do it, the way the system's set up is you can just put in all the addresses you're showing. So I'm getting these disclosures sent to me with the competition. People are looking at the one on Silver Pine, which is 3272 square feet. We're 3780. So we're right at 500 square feet bigger. And we're comparing. They're 1.4, we're 1.6. We got a nice big yard, cul-de-sac, that they don't have. So I'll take my chances on that comparison, especially if we find buyers who need 5 or 6 bedrooms, because we got it. But how about this? This is what I hate about this business. A guy, agent, gets a new listing on Silver Pine. I mean, almost across the street from that other listing. Puts it on the MLS today. Same floor plan as that, 13272 square feet. Is a coming soon listing, so you can't see it. Puts one photo in, the front exterior photo only, so you don't know what you're dealing with. And how about this price, 1.2. I'm 1.6. The house across the street from him is 1.4. And he lists for 1.2 even. But no showings, and just, you know, live with that. That really shouldn't even be allowed. That's not fair to us, for sure. And it's really not fair to the buyers, because buyers that might want to buy this one would like to compare to that one and check it out. But now they can't see it. They're not showing it for till the 17th. What's that, 10 days, 11 days? We need to fix that part, because that's not right. Scott Voak. Bringing a bribe.
Yeah. No, I've done these.
It's 5:00. It's another day at the plant. Love that new sign. Glows in the, well, reflective paint. A madhouse over here today. They just kept coming. People coming without even having an appointment. Two different people just showing up. Let's show agents showing up with their clients. People discussing other things they've seen today. People waiting in lines to get into houses. Waiting in lines. It is insane. We're list price 1.6. We're into the mid 1.7s. And it's a tense. I'll show you the park here. Great park. A little something for everybody. They even allow cookouts. See the hot ash thing over here? You can dump your barbecue right there. well-used part. People love the house because it is immaculate. Highly recommend staging and sprucing up the best you can. How's that for $150,000 over list price? Result, I think it's worth it. Dazzle them, and they'll come running. And call Jim the Realtor. Not one, two people willing to pay 1.75. What do you do? Just pick one? Pick your favorite? No. Listing agents should never put themselves in a position where they get to play God and pick their favorite. I told both of them, make your highest and best offer. Oh wait, I already did. I know. But when it's a tie like this, I'm not going to pick it. The market is going to decide it. You want to go up? Great. If you don't, that's okay too. Want to give both of you an equal chance to win. That way, everyone said it's a fair contest, and the market decided it. I'll let you know who the winner is. I'm Jim the Realtor.